There's not much to show for the wallpaper. I just cut strips of it at a certain width and then placed it on all the cascade ramps and around poles along the base of the castle. Here I used different colors of scrapbook paper and put it around the base of the entire castle. Now I'm going to show you what are called crenellations. I just take a piece of scrapbook paper, in this case you can use cardstock, and I cut strips that are 1 inch long, half an inch or a quarter inch wide, cut them out, folded them in half. Very simple. And then let's say I'm going to place it on that little tower right there. I just put the glue on the inside, the entire inside, and I clamp them over the lip of the tower and I just squeeze them into place, and that's it. Pretty simple. Now I'm going to show you how to make a column. I just use regular laser printer paper and a pen. You can make it as wide as you want or as narrow as you want. The wider the better, because it's more sturdy that way. I just roll it over the pen, leaving a little flap sticking out. I pull the pen out. I tamp it down, or whatever the word is, press it down to make it even, and then put glue on the flap. Press it down to hold it in place. Then once I'm done with that, I cut a strip of paper that I'm going to use for decoration on the column. Just put glue on it. Here you can either do a spiral, or you can just wrap it around, you know, wrap little pieces of it around to create stripes. I like the barber pole effect. I try to get it as parallel as possible, evenly spaced. Once I have that in place, I want to cover up the ends of that spiral to make it look better. And for that, I just use strips of paper. So I cut the strips to a certain length. Here I'm not measuring it, I usually measure it out. I take the strip and I measure it around the circumference of the pole or the column, leaving a little overlap. I cut it. Then using my thumbnail, I curve it. Then glue it into place. That's what I'm trying to cover up, that little end right there. It doesn't look very good. You can actually create your own Lincoln logs this way. It's something I haven't done yet, but you could create little log houses creating columns like this. Someday I'm going to try that. You can use the pen to press inside and so the column will keep its shape. Okay, now I'm going to close the top, and so I just put glue on it. This is a real simple way to do it. Then I cut a square of paper. Press the square onto the glue. Hold it in place until it takes. Then I turn the column upside down so I can see the shape of the column when I'm cutting the square into a rough circle. And I leave a little bit of an edge around the circle. It's about a quarter of an inch of an edge, a little less than that, and I score the circle all the way around. Now I could have cut it right to the edge of the pole, but it tends to be a little rough anyway, so I just do it this way. Although you could do that. I like to do it this way. Then you just press the edges down after gluing them. And it looks a little bit like a bottle cap. And as you'll see, it's going to look a little bit rough, but I'm going to cover that up. There's the roughness. And here again, I just measure a little strip of paper around it, around the circumference, leaving a little overlap. Cut it and curve it with your thumbnail. And then glue it in place. And there's your column with a cap on it. Looks pretty nice when you place it into the castle. There's one example. Here's an example with little balls of paper clay on top of them. And here's a little gazebo.